Hello and welcome to another episode of Review Revision. Now, in this episode, we're going to be looking at Denmark's entry. Now, it's Ove os par hinden, but it's better known to us as practicing on each other. Before we delve in then to Denmark's entry this year, let's have a little look back at their history, shall we? Well, Denmark has participated in the Eurovision Song Contest 48 times, making its first appearance back in 1957. Having competed in 10 consecutive contests until 1966, Denmark was then absent for 11 consecutive contests from there. But they've won three times. First in 1963 with Dan Sebais, performed by Greth and Jorgen Ingemann. And again in 2000 with the Olsen brothers and their song Fly on the Wings of Love.
In the summer night, when the moon shines bright, feeling love forever. And the heat is on, when the daylight's gone still.
And they also won in 2013 with the song Only Teardrops, performed by Emily DeForest.
How many times can we win and lose? How many times can we break the rules between us? Only teardrops. How many times do we have to fight? How many times do we get it right between us?
They're back this year with Ove os par hinanden. And Fyr Flamme. Let's have a little look at the song. Might have to re-record that after. So
it's just pure chaos. I love it.
It's going to be one of those episodes, I can tell. Right. Anyhow, what do we all think then? Emily, let's go to you first.
I think it's quite interesting that it's kind of putting up a Danish language song, which I think is kind of the first time in over 20 years that Denmark has done that. It does, for me, it's a very kind of, it feels very like classic camp Eurovision, but in my kind of personal opinion, it's not necessarily done particularly well. I get that a lot of kind of, if you look on the kind of YouTube video for it, and it has a lot of dislikes, but then no one sees, everyone kind of feels almost like too scared to actually voice why they dislike it. And for me, I struggle to actually kind of put my finger on why I don't like it, because it does feel camp, it does feel classic Eurovision. It is kind of, again, very kind of 80s, which, you know, we've seen with kind of Greece's entry this year. But for me, I just don't click with it. And the live performance is quite kind of pitchy as well in places. And so I think it'll kind of struggle, and I don't think it'll kind of pick up votes, because they don't seem to be kind of the most strong kind of vocals. But yeah, for me, I'm not keen, and I can't kind of place why, but yeah.
Okay, interesting. So the key takeaway there, sort of not keen, not sure why. What are you thinking, Jack? Are you along the same sort of route?
Yeah, I think you've pretty much said everything I wanted to say. There's nothing wrong with it, but there's quite a lot that's not quite right about it either. It's a strange one that it's, I think that the beginning bit where the sort of the riff, whatever it's called, whether it's a guitar, where I think that is really, really good. And that, and the first 5 or 10 seconds, I'm like, oh yeah, this is going to be good. And then as soon as the vocals start, and it's not the fact that it's in Danish, because I don't have a problem with foreign lyrics at all. I'm indifferent to whether it's in English or not. But as soon as it starts singing, it almost turns into like the demo version. It just feels a little bit cheap and a little bit 80s, but not the right bit of the 80s. And I think that perhaps is the issue with it. It just feels like it's not quite as polished as it should be. And when you've got other songs that are inspired by the 80s, like Grease in particular, this doesn't stand up as well to it. And bear in mind that Grease is in the same semi-final as this. You've got two songs that are in the same ballpark, but Grease does it significantly better than this. And I think, yeah, there's a slight vocal pitchiness to it. It's, yeah, there's just something that doesn't quite work. And it does just feel like the demo version. Like, they submitted this and then we're like, actually, no, that'll do. Well, yeah, we'll just stick with that. It'll be fine. But really, it could just do with it. This is a sort of the type of song that really demands a revamp. And they haven't given it a revamp when they probably could have done. If they wanted it to qualify, I think it quite easily it would have deserved a revamp, but they haven't. Yeah, it's decent enough. It's not my famous, it's not my favorite Danish entry by any means, but I do respect that they have gone for the first Danish entry of my lifetime, actually. First time since 1997, they've gone for a song in Danish. So I respect that. Not 100% up my street, though.
Yeah, I think I very much agree with what both of you have said. And I think it is a bit of a, it is a bit of a bizarre one. I mean, you know, I love it. I think it's very Eurovision, it's very 80s, so two of my sort of favourite things. But then I get also like what you're saying, it's that sort of thing that is just lacking and you don't really know what that is. And it, I think it is like you said, Jack, as well, it's that sort of unpolished element of it is the key thing that sort of is the off-putting thing. I mean, I quite like the sort of dancing and I like the sort of outfits and things as well. I think that's quite good, but there's just something about it. I mean, I've got to be honest, we'll come to the score shortly. I don't remember putting it as high as I did. So before going into too much detail, we'll find out in a bit. But obviously when I listened to it for the first time, I really loved this. So God knows where I was. But anyway, before we get to that, what are we all thinking? Will it do well? Will it, you know, will it score well on the leaderboard? Emily, what are your thoughts?
I don't think it'll qualify, and I don't think it's kind of helped by where it's placed in the semi-final, because it's going kind of last. And I think, you know, the show should be kind of bending on high, and this doesn't do that, which is kind of a shame. So I think it'll struggle to qualify. I think people won't get it, which is kind of, yeah. For me personally, it's my number 34, so really kind of quite low. I am one of those people who is not getting it. But yeah, I'm not sure it'll qualify.
Interesting. What are you thinking, Jack? You're along the same sort of lines.
Yeah, along the same sorts of lines. It's closing the semi-final, which is perhaps the strangest, since they started getting producers to pick the running order, I think this is possibly the strangest way to close a show yet. I don't really get the rationale for it. And I think, I mean, this half of the semi is a pretty drab one anyway. And I think Latvia would have possibly been a better show closer. Or even, is Serbia in this half as well? If it is, I think that Serbia would have been a really good show closer, but they've gone for this. And I think it's a strange one. And I think Emily, again, to echo what Emily said, I don't think people will get it really. If it does go through, I don't think it will. I think it'll probably sit around the 13th, 14th in the semi mark. If it does go through, it will be in 10th place, as it was in 2019. Leonora squeaked through in 10th and ended up doing quite well in the final. I think that will be a similar thing here, but I think it is far more likely than not that it will not qualify. And just again, just because it does go last doesn't mean that it will automatically, it will definitely qualify. Because we had Latvia 2017, they were the show closer, were very divisive like this, ended up coming last in the semi, undeservedly. It was, I mean, that was a much, much better song than this. And yeah, so I'm not convinced it will qualify. Within my personal ranking, it's 32. On reflection, maybe a little bit harsh. It's grown on me a little bit since I put my ranking in, but it didn't have the immediacy and the immediate likability that it needs to do well at Eurovision. So I don't think it will qualify, and it's my 32.
Okay, I mean, right, yeah. I put it as my number 8.
What?
I don't know why I did that. I've got to be honest.
You put that at 8. Hang on. Whoa. You put that at 8 and you put France at 28. That is like a crime against music.
No, that's just the way it should be. But
no, but 8. I mean, that is very general.
Well, I've got to be honest. Like,
it's no words.
But it's a general... I'm sorry, there's a train going past. It's a genuine thing. Like, I don't understand how I put it as number 8.
Yeah, neither do we. No, nobody understands literally what is going on.
Like, throughout all of the episodes, I've known what I was thinking about it. And even looking at my notes, like I put a double tick next to it on my notes to say like I really liked it. So I don't quite know what's happened. And like I've listened to it since, and I'm really not that big of a fan of it now. So I think Denmark need to just make sure they prove everybody wrong. Impress the audience, impress the jury, and do well for me, because otherwise I'm mortifyingly embarrassing myself here.
Yeah, you already have. This is on record. This is going to be online forever.
I do often forget about that. Anyhow, the collective score is 74. So, you know, poor Denmark. That's all I'll say.
Ethan's doing a lot of lifting there for their score.
I feel like I have... probably saved them from quite a bit of embarrassment there. But yeah, I mean, honestly, I don't know what I was thinking at the time. Maybe something will come to me in the next few days. Until then, you're as clued up as I am. Nevertheless, comment below if you agree with me. I'll be very surprised. But if you do, you know, drop a comment. Give us a like. If you enjoyed it, subscribe. Hit the bell icon. And follow us on social media too if you want to, why not? @reveurovision. Plenty of content there too. And we'll see you tomorrow. Bye bye.